Hallo und herzlich willkommen zu einer weiteren Episode von Whisperer in Darkness hier auf diesem Kanal. Und heute geht es weiter mit Kapitel Nummer 4, das sich chronologisch zwischen Kapitel Nummer 3 und Kapitel Nummer 5 einreiht. Auch hier wieder wird der Text Englisch sein, das heißt, ich werde fliegend zwischen den Sprachen wechseln, soweit es mir möglich ist, und darum sind möglicherweise Englischkenntnisse für den Genuss dieses Videos notwendig. Aber ich habe schon ein bisschen zu viel geredet jetzt. Wollen wir mal gucken, dass wir losgehen, sonst ruiniert das die ganze gruselige Stimmung. Gut, bis dann. Bis dann. Los geht's! Ja, Kapitel 4, genau. At this point, Akeley's emails began to arrive with greater frequency and describing still more startling events at the farmhouse. Email from H. Wakely at zmail.com. The unknown things have begun to close in on me with a frightening new degree of determination. I suspect they mean to kill me because of our correspondence and because I've learned too much. I never should have sent you that recording or the Black Stone. They may now be watching you as well. Be vigilant. I've long known they keep human allies to act as agents and spies. You yourself heard the human voices in my recording that night. Now, I believe, I have identified one of their human agents, Walter Brown, a surly farmer who lives alone on a rundown hillside place near the deep woods. I have heard his voice in terrible conversations in the woods. I've also seen claw prints near his house. I've never encountered a hint of their presence on nights when the moon is full and bright, for these creatures shun the light. The nocturnal barking of my dogs has grown hideous on moonless nights. Yesterday, on my way to the village by car, I was stopped by a tree trunk laid in my path at a deep patch of the woods. Luckily, I had two of my great dogs with me, whose savage barking warned me of the things which must have been lurking near. I never leave home without my dogs now. Who knows what would have happened if I had been alone. The next email came in the evening, and I judged it was written in a hurry. Frightful happenings last night. Bullets flying outside the farmhouse while my dogs ran frenzied from the barn to find the source of the noise. A few quickly returned to shelter while the rest went chasing after the threat. Ugh. Found three of those 12 dogs dead this morning. Myriads of claw prints in the road. Human prints also, probably Walter Brown's. Wire went dead as I phoned Battleboro for more dogs. Later went by car. Bought four new guard dogs, nicht so schwierig, and several cases of rifle ammo. Phone company found the cable cleanly cut at a point we had crossed the deserted hills north of Newfane. Okay. This is terribly frightening news. Surely you must inform the authorities. Maybe if we can get them to believe your story, they could be of help. I know you want me to stay away, but maybe I could visit to help you explain your situation to the police. My corroboration might lend credence to your situation. Despite all Despite all our evidence, the police will never believe any of this. And if they did, a good armed force could wipe out the mining colony these beings have created. That is what the Migo are afraid of. But more would return from their planet. And though their armies have never bothered to conquer Earth, it is only because they have not needed to. I appreciate the offer, but there's nothing you can do. It would only hurt both of us. Are you sure? Still, you could flee elsewhere. Do you have any family or a place you could stay in the meantime? You may be better off leaving Vermont entirely, I'm afraid. I was bewildered by your last message until I checked the history of our conversation. I never sent the last email you received, nor did I ever receive your previous offer to help. Things are much worse than we thought. Things are much worse than we thought. If they've successfully altered our communications, I've changed my password, and you should do the same. I have a daughter in California. I'm arranging to go live with her, but I've lived in this house my entire life. Maybe if I can prove to the aliens that I mean no harm and will explore no further, the situation will improve. This is certainly a distressing development. I changed my password and found no evidence of any tampering with my emails. Let me know if anything else happens. I will help you in any way I can. The next three messages came in quick succession, each arriving the morning after the last. Bad news, last night was thickly cloudy, though no rain and not a bit of moonlight got through. Things were pretty bad, and I think the end is getting near in spite of our hopes. After midnight, they started to arrive. One of the winged things must have flown to the roof, for I heard a terrible scratching from above as it landed, and a thump as one of the dogs rolled across here, nearly falling off the edge. I think it caught the monster by its leg as it took flight. There was a terrible flight up there, punctuated by a frightful buzzing. A death shriek? Then there came a putrid smell. Right then, bullets shattered the window and nearly grazed me. I put out the light and fired out the window, raking all around the house with rifle fire, aimed high enough to miss the dogs. Everything died down after that, but what I found in the morning was terrible. Pools of blood were left in the yard, besides pools of a green, sticky substance that smelled positively foul. I climbed on the roof and found more of the sticky stuff there. I still don't know what was up there. Five of the dogs were killed. One of them was shot in the back. I'm afraid I hit it by accident, aiming too low. Now I'm replacing the panes. The shots broke and I'm off to Battleboro for more dogs. Surely the volunteers at the kennel think I've become unhinged. I think I'll be ready to move in a week or two. But it kills me to think of it. Clouds didn't break, so no moon again. It's waning anyway. I'd put in a damned searchlight if I didn't know that they'd just cut the cables as fast as they could be repaired again. I must be losing my mind. They talked to me last night in their cursed buzzing voices. I cannot repeat the hideous things they told me over the barking of the dogs. Stay out of this, Wilma. It's worse than we ever suspected. They don't mean to let me leave Vermont. They wish to take me alive, away outside the galaxy. I told them I wouldn't go where they wish, or in the terrible way they wish to take me. But I fear it will be no use. Six more dogs killed. I felt presence all along the wooded parts of the road when I drove to Battleboro today. It is horrible. The last email instilled in my chest a frigid hopelessness so fraught with anxiety that I could not respond. No use in discussing anything anymore. I'm fully resigned. I have only enough willpower left to fight them off. Can't escape, even if I were willing to leave everything and run. They'll get me. Had a letter from them yesterday, posted on my front door. Walter Brown must have left it. The creatures couldn't have gotten so close with the dogs about. It tells what they want to do with me. I shudder to imagine it. Still cloudy night, and the moon waning. I wish I dared to get help, but no one will believe me, and I'm too far out of touch. I have been for years. The worst part is, I've seen and touched one of these things. This TH is echt schwierig. Things. God, it was awful. Dead, of course. One of the dogs had it. I found it near the barn this morning. I tried to take a photo, but areas of the Migo's skin seemed to have reflected the light from my camera so strongly that my image revealed only darkness, penetrated by a sinister constellation of stars and streaming lights. Just as I took my first photo, the body began to disintegrate so rapidly that the only photos I could take thereafter showed nothing but the dirt and an abundance of the same green fluid I'd seen before. You know, those things in the rivers were only ever seen on the first morning after the flood, and explorers who saw figures in the woods always claimed it was difficult or impossible to take good pictures of them. It all makes sense now, how these things have stayed secret so long. This may be goodbye. If it is, please write my daughter Grace Goodenough-Aigley. I fear to write her address here, lest they find her too. I've sent a letter containing her information. I pray to God it does not meet the same fate as the Blackstone. Write the girl if you don't hear from me in a week, and watch the papers for news. But don't come up here. I'm going to play my last two cards now, if I have the courage to. First, I will try poison gas on the things. I've got the chemicals and I've made masks for myself and the dogs. And if that doesn't work, I will call the police. They may put me in a mental ward, but it will be better than what the other creatures will do. I wish I hadn't become such a hermit. Folks don't drop around as they used to. Write my daughter if you don't hear soon. Don't mix up in this. Okay. Okay, das war wieder ein Kapitel. Dann bis zum nächsten Mal.